Hi guys, Rose here with the Cackling Moon, and this is your weekly oracle reading for the week of April 11th. April 11th, crazy, we're like flying by this month. Okay, so for this reading, I'm going to be using two decks. I'm going to be using the Halloween Oracle because last night I blacked out the edges of the deck, so I want to use it because the cards look really, really cool. And then I'm using the Radiant Rider-Waite Tarot because I also deck modded it. I trimmed the edges and I rounded the corners, so I wanted to use the cards as well. So for the reading, I will be pulling one card for the beginning of the week, middle of the week, and the end of the week, as well as a tarot deck or a tarot card for added insight. The whole vibe this weekend has been real fall-like. It's been really nice. The weather's been cold and raining off and on, so totally feeling the vibe of fall. And with that, I felt that this Halloween Oracle would just be perfect for the weekly reading. I can't wait for fall. I have so many spooky decks. So many dark decks that I want to use. So I'm just really looking forward to the fall season. Okay. So this will be the beginning, the middle, and the end of the week. And then we will do our tarot. So after deck modding the Radiant Rider-Waite, the cards are definitely much smaller, but it's kind of nice. I usually don't work with like small decks, but this makes it really, really easy to shuffle. So I could see why so many people prefer a smaller deck. I could totally see why, but I've always just been really fond of the larger size. Or the standard size, I guess you would say. Okay, so this will be the beginning, middle, and end. So beginning of the week, we have Skull of Stars and the Chariot. Skull of Stars says infinite possibility. So this is a really cool way to begin the week. Infinite possibilities is telling us that there are obviously multiple possibilities for this week. The beginning of the week looks to be positive. It looks to be full of inspiration. We have it matched with the Chariot card, and the Chariot is about fast-paced forward motion. It's about taking chances. It's about moving, traveling, progression. It's definitely an action card. And so I think it shows that the beginning of the week, there's going to definitely be a lot of forward movement, a lot of inspiration, just a lot of things coming your way. A lot of ideas might be birthed within this first week, or this first couple days of the week. So a really cool, really positive card to receive for the beginning of our week. Middle of the week, we got Lady de los Muertos, acceptance and equality. And then we also got it matched with the King of Swords. So acceptance and equality, this is within ourselves. This is the way that we look at ourselves, accepting ourselves for who we are, and being well balanced with one another. I think this is also a team playing card as well. So for those of us who go to school or going to work, this is, remembering to be a team player, but also staying true to yourself. The King of Swords, this can indicate maybe someone in a higher position from us. So if this is a workplace, this could be a boss, this could be a supervisor of some sort, who, we're going to be reminded to kind of be balanced and be, accepting of maybe tasks that are asked of us for the week. There might be some challenges coming up with this person, where we might feel like they're just kind of picking on us a little bit. King of Swords is definitely somebody who has the upper hand in a situation. The King of Swords isn't afraid to express their feelings, and they are very analytical people. So, acceptance and equality, it's just kind of accepting yourself. If you are okay and you are comfortable with yourself, then when you are matched with somebody who might be giving you a little bit of a challenge in the week, it's easier to kind of deal with that kind of situation and that type of a person, because you are comfortable with who you are and you know what you're supposed to do. You know your job, you know your role in life. It just makes everything a lot easier. So middle of the week might be a little bit of a challenge. You might be kind of eager for the weekend to get here, which brings us to the weekend cards. So we got joy, rejoicing in the present, and we got it matched with the Two of Wands. So for the joy card to come up, this shows we are actually very, very pleased and very excited to finally have the weekend upon us. So like I said, the middle of the week might prove to be a little bit challenging with someone in a more supervisory role. The weekend will be coming in, and we're just going to feel like it's just what we need. We needed this weekend. We needed this time off. Some of us might have some plans. Some of us are just enjoying the present time. We're not focusing on the past. We're not focusing on work. We're not focusing on school. We're just enjoying our day right now in the present. And then matched with the Two of Wands, it just kind of shows there's just so many other opportunities that might be beckoning you. You might be called to do other things. There might be some other interests popping up for you in this weekend time. This weekend time might be a time for reflection of, just kind of trying to decide where you want to be within the next, month or so, by the end of the month or whatnot. Just a lot of ideas popping in your mind. A lot of times when we're challenged with certain people in higher positions, it does cause us to want to kind of, explore and to see what else is out there, what other things is available for us, aside from our present positions or classes that we're taking or whatnot. So a lot of a lot of good energy this week. I think it's going to be a busy week. I really feel when we're starting off with the Chariot, and then we have this authoritative figure in the reading, it just does feel like a lot of fast-paced work, a lot of work to be done, a lot of expectations. So I think that once the weekend gets here, it's going to be well deserved, and we are going to just be able to throw up our hands and celebrate to know that we have some time to ourselves. So get ready, you guys. Get ready for a really busy week. Get ready for a lot of inspiration, a lot of ideas, a lot of fast-paced movement, maybe some difficult people. And just get through the week, you guys. We can all do this. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later.